Now, 3D scaling. As we know in the previous, the scaling is nothing but the zooming the object from XY plane with from size of 1:1:1 is zoomed to 2:2:2. This is called a scaling. Now, the zooming is nothing but, or the scaling is nothing but, change the size of the object and repositions the object relative to the coordinate origin. In this picture, the pyramid is shown, the blue pyramid is shown near to the origin. Now, we can say that this is the XY plane. Now, we do the scaling operation. That is a 3D scaling operation. That pyramid is get enlarged 2 or 3 times, and that enlarges cube obviously having the different dimensions, so it will be in either what we call the increase in shape or decrease in shape. So in both the cases the coordinate system will going to change. With this accordance we can see that the in our case the initial pyramid is having the unit cube value and it is multiplied by twice, so it will get double in size. So we come to the mathematical formulation. We can say that where the Sx is equals to the scale factor in x direction. So the pyramid get scaled in x direction, Sy scale factor in the y direction, the pyramid get scaled in y directions, and the Sz scale factor in the z direction, that the pyramid get in z direction. And that can be represented mathematical formation, that is a matrix formation, the matrix of the modified function, that is x dash y dash z dash 1 is equals to the scaling matrix Sx 0 0 0 0 Sy 0 0 0 0 Sz 0 0 0 0 1 is multiplied by the initial function matrix x y z 1. This is called scaling. That can be represented in the form of equation, that is x dash, this is a scaling equation, so basically x dash, that is a modified of x dash, is equals to initial of x multiplied by the scaling of Sx. Similarly goes for the y dash equals to y multiplied by Sy, z dash equals to z multiplied by Sz. Here you can see this doll initially in the left side, it is in quite small in size. After doing the 3D scaling operation, that you can see the doll is get bigger in shape or size. This is called generally 3D scaling. Now come to the next slide, that is a 3D reflection. Many of the see, that is a lot of screensaver you can see on the mobiles, that is the moon or something on the screen is having the reflection on the water. You can see on the many screensaver of the mobiles, computers, this is the effect of the 3D reflection. Now here's how the 3D reflection, or the we can see the basic concept of 3D reflection. 3D reflection in a computer graphics is used to emulate reflective object like mirrors and shiny surfaces. Okay, so this is basically nothing but it will reflect the object along with the in waving pattern. So the reflection may be an x-axis, y-axis, z-axis, and also in planes xy plane, yz plane and zx plane. So reflection is nothing but the mirroring operation along the particular xz, xy, zx plane. So reflection relative to given axis are equivalent to 180 degree rotation. So come to the next slide, coordinate system. Generally the global model world coordinate systems is used in CAD softwares. The CAD software stores the graphical information, that is the coordinate data, in the model database with the reference to the coordinate system known as a model coordinate or world coordinate or global coordinate system. So global coordinate system GCS is the reference space of the model with respect to which all the model's geometrical data is stored. This is the only coordinate system that the modeling software recognizes when storing or retrieving the graphical data sets. Now, as in the previous lectures, I already told you that there are types of coordinate system, that is the local coordinate system and global coordinate system. What if you use AutoCAD or any software and we just open it, then you can see the blank space in the editor or in the screens. After the AutoCAD is open, the blank space or the black screen is there. This is called global coordinate system. This global coordinate system is recognized by the software inbuilt with the help of the coordinate system. Now suddenly if we draw any geometry in the space, so is that geometry is in XYZ equals to 000 plane? No, we draw with the help of local coordinate system. Along with that, we called what we call along with the planes or along with the space coordinate system. It's very simple actually. कैसा है, अगर आप AutoCAD ओपन करते हो तो AutoCAD में आपको एक ब्लैंक स्पेस दिखाई देता है, तो उसको आप ये बोलते हो कि वो ये है ग्लोबल कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम है. लेकिन मैं अगर उसमें एक ऑब्जेक्ट ड्रा करता हूँ, सपोज सर्कल ड्रा करता हूँ उधर ऊपर ही, तो वो सर्कल कहीं पे भी ड्रा हो जाता है. तो उसके आपको डायमेंशंस, उसके आपको कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम देखना रहेगा ना. अब यू कैन सी ऑन द लेफ्ट बॉटम स्क्रीन ऑफ द AutoCAD सॉफ्टवेयर, it will show you something x 500 y 30 z 90. So this is the basically coordinate system. Now again I am going to draw that circle. I will put with the help of the coordinate, I will put in the command like this way, circle, that will ask me the in the coordinate x equals to 0, y equals to 0, z equals to 0. Okay, so that the circle is always draw from the its center. So that center point, it will be placed on global coordinate system x, y, z equals to 0, 0, 0. So I will put that radius equals to 10. Got it? This is called global coordinate system. Now what happened if there is a one circle and there is another big circle, means circle of 10 radius and another circle of 2 radius, 20 radius. So there are two circles, and if you are going to overlap to each other, we will merge with those circle with the help of the center of those center point of the circles. So here the coordinate system play the very important role, both having the center point, both circle having the center point of radius. So we will assign them x, y, z, we will assign them a coordinate system 1 for 10 radius circle, and we will assign the next coordinate system the 20 radius circle, and we will overlap with each other, that will the merge of the two circles. So this is how the coordinate system play the important role in our softwares. Now here the user and local coordinate system. In CAD modeling, the user input the graphical information, the coordinate data, with reference to the coordinate system known as user coordinate system or local coordinate system or working coordinate system. If the geometric model has a complex geometry or specific orientation, it is a highly convenient to input the graphical data in model coordinate system. In such a cases, for the convenience of the graphical data input, the coordinate system is defined with respect to the model and known as the user coordinate system. This coordinate system is defined by the user convenience of input of the graphical information. This is, I already told you that this is a local and global coordinate system and the local coordinate system. This is the how it is works. Now coming to the last slide, that is a screen coordinate system. Now many of the scene that is a if particular if you want to constrain your object or screen object, आपको एक आधा square draw करना है और उस square screen के बाहर नहीं जाना चाहिए, तो screen coordinate system भी रहता है actually. Screen is nothing but we call in the grid system in particular AutoCAD software. So this is the screen coordinate system. What are, so screen coordinate system
is also called SCS in 2D Cartesian coordinate system, whose origin located at the left, at the lower left corner of the graphical display screen. It is a display device dependent.
Here you can see that the origin is nothing but SCS along XY plane.
That is called screen coordinate system. This is nothing but, again, this is a local coordinate system. Having another local coordinate system is called screen coordinate system. Okay guys, this is a come to unit 1 is ended of the CAD CAM subject. Thank you.